Ladies and gentlemen, we're live at the Willy Wonka Chocolate Factory, where history is about to be made. We've been told that Mr. Wonka himself will soon be meeting us by these mysterious gates. Oh. Hey! Oh, I see something! Yes, it is! Yes, ladies and gentlemen, the chocolate genius of the century, Mr. Willy Wonka!
Mr. Wonka, may I have a few words, please?
Certainly. Balderdash, flummery, and prestidigitation. Three of my very favorites. Thank you. Lovely speaking with you. Come closer, my little friends. Gather round. Welcome to my factory. Augustus Kloop, please step forward.
Here's my golden ticket, Mr. Wonka. Now, then may I have something to eat?
Oh, he has a cold, poor baby. I'm Grossa Gorschnoffel.
My name is Veruca Salt.
Well, that's your misfortune, not mine. Besides, I always thought a Veruca was a wart, but you don't look like a wart at all. More of a mole or perhaps a bunion.
Good day, Wonka. Salt's a name, nuts a game. I'm totally nuts. Nuts for nuts, that is. An operation like this must go through a million nuts.
Make that a million and one. Your golden ticket, please.
Here's your silly ticket. Can I have it back after the tour?
Of course you can, my dear. Of course. Violet Beauregard.
I hear ya. Here's our ticket.
There's no gum chewing allowed on the tour.
But you make gum.
Violet Sugar, Mr. Wonka has asked you to remove your gum. Do we have to negotiate?
Psychobabble, whatever.
Mike TV? Mr. Mike TV and guest, your golden ticket, please.
Hold your golden horses, Professor. There's a Geico and a Nike commercial coming up. You don't often get a Geico and a Nike back to back.
I'm sorry. Here's our ticket, Mr. Wonka.
Scrumptious! Oh, and Mike, I'm happy to announce there's no television reception in the factory.
None.
None whatsoever. Ha! Chuck Bucket.
That's Charlie, Mr. Wonka. Charlie Bucket, here's our ticket.
So you're Charlie Bucket. Odd coincidence, you finding your ticket in the very last minute of the very last day.
Now, see here, Mr. Wonka. Our ticket's just as good as any of their
tickets.
Pleasure
to meet you, too, Mr.
You already know me, Mr. Wonka. Joe? Joe Bucket? I used to work for you?
Congratulations, so did I. All right, now, let's proceed. We begin with a contract. Ooh. Raise your right hand. I insert your name here.
I, Violet Mozart,
hereby swear not to touch, malign, assign.
Hereby swear not to touch, malign, or assign.
Clutch, share, tear, or wear none such party of the first part under penalty fitting of the grievance should such grievance occur. Not valid in all states. See store for details. Objects that may be closer than they appear to you, so swear.
I swear?
Hang on. Not without me lawyer first. Let me give him a call.
No mobile phones. Sign or leave. Sign. Now.
Come on, Wonks.
Are there any questions?
How long you think this is going to take? I got another important phone call in 20 minutes.
Any questions from the children?
Mr. Vonka, when may we have a snack? Augustus has low blood sugar.
And absolutely no photography of any kind. Good question, Augustus. In the Wonka Chocolate Factory, there are many thousand rooms.
Ooh.
I'll show you what some of them are. In this room here are the luminous lollies for eating in bed at night. And in that room there, the exploding sweets for whatever beats not a fight. In this room here is the rock candy mine. They say that it's 3 miles deep. And in that room there are the marshmallow pillows to munch when you just can't sleep.
Little rooms, big rooms,
high rooms, low rooms,
1,700 candy showrooms,
ballrooms,
bathrooms, ballrooms,
and you'll find chocolate in almost all rooms. In this room here are the chocolate pouches from which we get chocolate milk. In that room there are hot ice cream, cold day smooth as silk.
And in every room are chocolate miracles, dreams we all compare.
Driving rivals to despair, you should see them tear their hair. And all because
of this room here,
and 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 this room here, and that room there. I'd hate to lose any of you so early on our journey. Yes, is it everything? Now, stand in the middle. Now. If you want to see magic lights, close your eyes and you will see one. Wanna be a dreamer, be one. Anytime you please, and please save me one.
Please save me one.
Candy, all edible, and the chocolate river. Every single drop is the finest liquid chocolate known to man.
How much chocolate is in that river, Mr. Vonka?
Oh, probably enough chocolate to fill every bathtub and swimming pool in the entire country. I'd say 5 million gallons. Then again, it could be 5,000,001.
Hey, Vonka, what's the purpose of all these pots?
Once the chocolate has been churned to creamy perfection, those pipes carry it to each and every room of my factory.
Look over there. It's some sort of creature.
Freeze! Put your hands up in the air where I can see it, Punk.
No need to worry. That, my friends, is an Oompa Loompa.
A zombie worker.
Not a zombie worker. A refugee.
A
Maggie, yeah. Augustus, hot and cold runny chocolate.
No matter how tempting, you must not under any circumstances touch the chocolate. Now back to the Oompa Loompas. All of my workers are Oompa Loompas from Loompa Land.
Now see here, Wonka, I am a geography teacher and I have never, ever...
And you should know all about Loompa Land, with its thick jungles infested by hornswogglers and snazzy wagglers and terrible vermicious canids and wicked old wang doodles.
Wang doodles? There's no such thing.
We are the music makers, and we are the dreamers of the dreams. Augustus, didn't I say quite recently that my super special chocolate must never be touched by human hands, especially yours?
Foolish.
Great, now a million people are going to get his coal.
It's so good. I think the chocolate is going to trunk it.
You were down!
See him? He's in the pipe! The big one!
Oh my gosh! Though not big enough, it seems. Not even I have need for a gloop-sized pipe.
Augustus, get out of that pipe this very instant!
He looks like he's stuck!
He is stuck, Charlie!
Oh my god, in Himmel! He is gestucken!
5, 4, 3, 2... We've had a slight early setback and lost a great big fat greedy child in the chocolate river. Shame, really. The boy really seemed to know his food.
He'd be mashed like a marshmallow.
Impossible. That pipe goes nowhere near the marshmallow room. It leads to the strawberry dipping room.
Oh, strawberry dipping room.
Where he will be heated to a temperature of 88 degrees Fahrenheit. Or is that Celsius? I often get the two mixed up, sometimes with tragic consequences. In any case, please accompany Mrs. Gloop to the strawberry dipping room, and when you get there, take a long, sharp stick and start poking around the chocolate mixing barrel. Chances are you'll find him there. However, make haste. If you leave him too long, he's likely to be poured into the fudge boiler, and that would be a tragedy. Could damage the machinery.
Oh, Augustus could be damaged, too.
Frau Gloop, Augustus was damaged a long time ago. The real tragedy, as far as I'm concerned, is all the wasted chocolate. Goodbye, Mrs. Gloop. Auf Wiedersehen. Good night. Shall we carry on?
Yes. Follow me, stay close. We want to talk to ourselves.
Loompa, doopity doo. I've got a perfect puzzle for you. Oompa, loompa, doopity dee. If you are wise, you'll listen to me.
What do you get when you guzzle down sweets?
Eating as much as an elephant eats.
What are you at? Getting terribly fat.
What do you think will come of that?
I don't like the look of it. Oompa, loompa, doopity da.
If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too. Like the oompa, loompa, doopity doo.
Now continue the rest of our journey by boat. not lick the boat, you'll only make it sticky.
Excuse me, Mr. Wonka, I just love your hat. It really sets off your eyes. But of course you have great taste. You know, I would simply adore a pink candy boom and maybe one of those sweet little Oompa Loompas to drive it for me.
All right. I know when it's time to get out the old checkbook. Name your price, Wonka, and don't take me on too much of a boat ride. A little joke there, you get it? You may need me nuts one day.
Bad parent says what?
What?
I said, a bad parent says what?
What?
Exactly.
Wonka, where have you taken us?
Simmering in here. Right over here. Fantastic invention. It'll revolutionize the industry. This is an everlasting gobstopper. You can suck them and they'll never get any smaller. Now, you can each have one, but you must all solemnly swear never to show anyone outside the walls of this factory for as long as you may live. Do we have an agreement?
I agree.
Okay, one for you, and one for you, and one for you, and one for you. And over here, my newest invention, I'm very proud of it, the everlasting gummy gourmet gobstopper machine. Hit it, Oompa Loompas. Ta-da! The everlasting gummy gourmet gobstopper.
It looks like gum.
That's because it is gum. The most dazzling gum in the world.
Gum, oh no.
An entire gourmet meal without any of those nasty calories. Unfortunately, it can't be chewed yet. So you can only look at it.
I only have one dream in life, there's very little to it. Chew one stick of lifelong gum and all lifelong to chew it. I chew it all through childhood, I chew it when I win. If I survive to 95, I chew it till I'm dead.
But this gum here's much better than that gum. This gum here is a three-course dinner. Pea soup, roast beef and blue. Berry ice cream, blue. Berry is the nicest ice cream. You may feel fat, but in fact you're thinner. Even after a three-course dinner.
That gum is so mine!
Oh my God.
It really tastes like pea soup. Oh, and here comes the roast beef. Fantastic!
But the blueberry ice cream.
I bet it's the dye.
That's what I'm worried about. The dye.
Your violet, you're so busted.
That gum is gonna do it.
Her candy fate's gone down the drain.
I told her not to chew it.
Too late, Willie. Nothing to it. Cause I know she's had it. Chew it. There is no need to poo-poo it. All I have to do is chew it.
Violet, it's so bad for you.
You, Violet.
Violet, what you gonna do? Just stand there singing, am I blue?
Yes, she's turning blue, it's true. Oh, Violet, you are now bright blue.
That rotten, lousy gum, I knew it. Blueberry blue and fat as suet.
Well, well, well. Two naughty, nasty little children gone. Three good, sweet little children left. Or right, or wrong. We'll see.
Mr. Wonka, will Violet ever be all right, or will she always be a blueberry?
Very probably. At least I hope so. Pity, really. She showed so much promise as a gum-chewing prodigy. Ah, well. Come along. Much see to more. Strike that. Reverse it. Ah! Quite forgot about this room. It's the fizzy lifting drink room.
Bubbles. Do these bubbles taste like candy? Mr. Wonka, sweetie, I want bubbles that taste like candy. Here we
go. Actually, the bubbles taste like soap for children with dirty mouths. It's what the bubbles do that is remarkable.
Why? What do they do, Wonka?
Just one sip of my fizzy lifting drink and you will float on air.
Float on air?
Yes. Unfortunately, my legal advisors have forbidden us from taking even the tiniest taste, something to do with air traffic control. Anyway, not important. More exciting things to show you. Columbus.
Grandpa Joe! Oh,
Charlie!
Sorry.
It's okay. It's okay. Come on, let's go.
Where's Mr. Wonka and the kids?
I think they went through the bubbles.
Okay, let's go.
I'm pretty sure we must have taken a wrong turn. I think this is the fizzy lifting drink room.
You think that's the fizzy lifting drink?
Maybe.
You know, Charlie, you always wanted to fly. Why don't you try a little bit?
Well, I suppose one tiny taste wouldn't do any harm.
I'm flying.
There's no sensation that's quite as sensational as flying.
Thrilling, fulfilling, and higher educational as flying.
It's inspirational
and recreational trying. Way, way up there in midair to be touching the sky. Which I guess is why there is no feeling that's quite like the feeling of flying.
Bumping your head on the ceiling so high up above. It's so appealing, I'm reeling and identifying.
Flying, I love. There is no high end as high as the high I am trying. Flying, I love. What's that sound, Charlie?
I don't know. It's getting louder, though. We better float down.
Look out, it's a fan! It's pulling us up! Try to swim down, Charlie!
I can't.
Try, Charlie, try!
I can't!
Charlie, we're gonna get cut to bits!
Think positive!
I can't!
Think! Oh, that's better.
Wait! The burping is the answer!
This is fun! Whee! Oh, how I love to burp!
People burp from Atlanta to Antwerp!
From John Wayne to Wyatt Earp,
just like birds love to chirp,
every guy loves to B-U-R-P.
Happy birthday to me.
Thank you.
see, Veruca. Cocoa beans contain a variety of chemicals, the primary psychoactive components being theobromine and caffeine. Now, if we'll just work ourselves this way. Charlie, Grandpa Joe, please join the group. We wouldn't want you to float away, now would we? And welcome to the Nut Room.
Oh, Nut Room. That's what I'm talking about, Veruca.
Mr. Wonka, are those squirrels?
Thus explaining their enormous similarity to squirrels. These squirrels have the ability to shell a walnut in one piece and at the same time sort the good nuts from the bad nuts. Do not disturb the squirrels. They are in training.
See here, Wonka, I want a squirrel, and what I want, I get.
Right. Checkbook's ready.
I want a squirrel and an Oompa-Loompa. And I want a squirrel and an Oompa-Loompa and a pink candy bar, and while we're at it.
Generally only lit every other day, and I can't remember if today's a burn day. Guess we'll have to find out. Shame, really. She was so deliciously bossy, self-centered, thoughtless, and uneducated. Would have made a wonderful Kardashian. Oh, well. Onward and upward, backward and forward, please exit this way!
Oompa, loompa, doopity-doo. I've got a perfect
everybody wearing their protective gear?
Sort of.
Good. Now, please place the goggles over your eyes. And welcome to the Choco Vision Room.
What is this? Some kind of television studio?
Or for making Wonka commercials.
Wrong. You're all familiar with how television works, right? You'll have to speak a little louder. I'm a trifle deaf in this ear.
I said, what does that do?
I'm a trifle deaf in that ear as well.
What's the loompy oompy doing?
Ah, well, you see, television gave me a wonderful idea. If you could send a picture by television, why not a candy bar?
But that's impossible.
It's very possible. Imagine, sitting at home watching television, and suddenly you see a commercial. Try a Wonka bar. Try it now. And then, poof! It's right there in front of you. One simple touch of that switch right there on that camera, but it has not been properly tested yet, therefore nobody is allowed to touch it.
Look at me! Look at me! I'm gonna be on TV!
Stop, don't, come back.
He's gone!
Oh dear, I do hope some part of him is not left behind. I've never transmitted a person before.
Hey look, something's happening!
Mike, I told you not to touch.
That was your first mistake, fool. I want to do it again and again. Put me down. Put me down. I want to be on TV.
He's completely unharmed.
Unharmed? He thinks it's his toe.
Yes, well, I can see how that's a problem. But don't worry. Young boys are generally very springy and stretchy. Ah. The taffy pulling machine. That ought to do it.
How far do you think he'll stretch?
Oh, who knows? Could be mine! Well, thank you both very much for coming. I'm sure you can find your own way out.
You mean that's it? What about our lifetime supply of chocolate?
Oh yes, that, the chocolate. Don't worry, each child will receive their chocolate. Other than that, the day has been a total waste of time. I had high hopes for you, Charlie, but you broke the rules. You stole fizzy lifting drinks. Now I'm extraordinarily busy. I must be going. Good day.
Mr. Wonka?
I'm sorry for breaking the rules. I don't deserve a lifetime supply of chocolate. Oh, and here. You can have your gobstopper back. I wouldn't show anyone in the world. But thank you for a wonderful day and the most wonderful tour of your factory. It was better than Christmas.
So shines a good deed in a weary world. Charlie. My boy. You did it! You did it! You won!
Did what, Mr. Wonka?
Mr. Wonka, the fizzy lifting drink, that was all me!
Never mind that, Grandpa Joe, sir, please. You see, I created this entire thing with one intention, to find a new child to make new candy dreams come true and replace me.
I don't understand.
This entire tour was a test of character, Charlie. All the other kids gave in to temptation, as did you. But you're the only one capable of showing me your loyalty and your honesty. This is scrumdiddlyumptious. We have to get on. We have to get on. We have so much time, so little to do. Strike that. Reverse it. Come this way, please. Yes. Time will tell, Charlie, my boy. Step up to the great glass Wonkavator.
I thought the tour was over, Mr. Wonka.
Our tour is just beginning, my dear sir. Charlie, press that button way up there. No, not that one, that one. Yes. Now hold on tight. We're going up and out.
Up and out?
Hold on tight.
Whoa!
This is it. Here we go.
Whee!
We're flying.
What?
He lived happily ever after.
can!
Oh, Charlie can!
I know that he can.
We know that he can. We know that he can. 'Cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good.